Hi everyone, my name is Carlos and I'm going to introduce you to the concept of machine learning. Those are the main learning objectives: understanding what is AI and its history, define machine learning, distinguish main approaches and tribes. First, we have an important question. What is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence, or AI, refers to the development of computer-based solutions that can perform tasks which imitate human intelligence. In 1950, Alan Turing proposed the imitation game, later called the Turing test. It tests the machine's ability to exhibit intelligent behavior indistinguishable from that of a human. The Dartmouth Summer Research Project on Artificial Intelligence was a 1956 summer workshop. It was widely considered to be the founding event of artificial intelligence as a field. This event was hosted by John McCarthy and Marvin Minsk. The 50s and 60s corresponds to the first AI boom. It was the age of reasoning and heuristic search. Then there was a period called the first AI winter. Some expectations were not met. The 80s and 90s was the age of knowledge representation. Researchers and practitioners developed many expert systems capable of reproducing human decision making. Prolog and Lisp flourished as main programming languages in the context of AI. The 90s was the period of the second AI winter. In 1997, Deep Blue beats Garry Kasparov. In 2006, the University of Toronto develops deep learning. In 2011, IBM's Watson won Jeopardy. In 2018, Joshua Bengio, Geoffrey Hinton and Ian LeCun won the ACM Turing Award. Machine learning is a type of artificial intelligence that enables systems to learn patterns from data and subsequently improve from experience. As it gathers and organizes more information, machine learning constantly gets better at identifying types and forms of data with little or no hard code rules. Machine learning is also the scientific study of algorithms that computer systems use to perform specific tasks without using explicit instructions. Machine learning consists of studying and constructing algorithms that can learn from and make predictions on data. For example, through patterns recognition, machine learning will increase the accuracy of identifying specific objects or images. Pedro Domingos, a professor from the University of Washington, suggests that in the context of machine learning, there are five groups of researchers that use five different approaches. Analogizers are interested in mapping new situations. They are influenced by psychology. Analogizers use algorithms like KNN and SVM. Bayesians use statistic inference. They are influenced by statistics. Bayesians use hidden Markov models, graphical models, and causal inference. Connectionists use neural networks. They are influenced by Neuroscience connectionists rely on deep learning technology, including CNN and RNN. It means convolutional neural networks and recurrent neural networks, and also deep reinforcement learning. Evolutionaries are interested in evolving structure. They are influenced by biology. Evolutionaries use genetic algorithms, evolutionary programming, and also evolutionary game theory. Symbolists use formal systems. They are influenced by computer science, linguistics, and analytic philosophy. Symbolists use decision trees, production rule systems, and inductive logic programming. Summarizing, we may identify five tribals: symbolists, connectionists, evolutionaries, Bayesians, and analogizers, with different origins and influences, like philosophy, neuroscience, evolutionary biology, statistics, and psychology. There are several types of machine learning. The most frequent organization consists in considering supervised learning and supervised learning and reinforcement learning. According to the data available and the purposes, we must choose one approach. Supervised learning is the machine learning task of learning a function that maps an input to an output based on example input-output pairs. Examples of usage, it is the classification and regression. The goal of unsupervised learning is to extract an efficient internal representation of the statistical structure implicit in the input. We can create, for example, clusters or, for example, perform the dimensional reduction. Reinforcement learning it is composed of three elements: agent, environment, and action performed by the agent. The purpose of reinforcement learning is to train an intelligent agent that is capable of navigating its environment and performing actions that arrives at the end of the goal. Action changes the state of the environment and the agent receives rewards or punishments. The challenges of the agent is to maximize the amount of rewards at the end of the specific period. The training data is used to make sure the machine recognizes patterns in the data. The cross-validation data is used to ensure better accuracy and efficiency of the algorithm used to train the machine. Test data used to see how well the machine can predict new answers based on its training. There are many tools that may be used in the context of machine learning. First, the Jupyter. It is a very good IDE, integrated development environment. Then Python is a good programming language, and we can find many libraries like NumPy, Pandas, StatsMod models, scikit-learn, and for example NetworkX. Summarizing, we define the concept of artificial intelligence and machine learning. Then we will also identify the main approaches of machine learning and tools that may be used.